Turkish engineers expect a major earthquake within the next 30 years that could crush their ancient capital city, Istanbul, and devastate Turkey's economy. Purdue University civil engineering professor Mete Sozan was commissioned to develop a bold proposal that would mitigate the impact on Turkey's political, cultural, and economic hub. Build from scratch a modern, earthquake-resistant city adjacent to Istanbul. The new satellite city would serve as a refuge for the more than 12 million residents of the old city.
No seismologist would be surprised if it happened today. If it does happen, the city may lose immediately some 120,000 of its citizens. Grim as that is, it is not the big problem. The big problem is that once this earthquake occurs, millions of people will be virtually in a state of siege in the city. It'll be very difficult to move. There'll be no water, there'll be no communication, no medication, no hospitals. It'll be a major disaster that'll make what happened in New Orleans recently like a picnic. And that is the problem. And if Istanbul collapses, I think so will the Turkish Republic.
That's why we're making this test.
Sozan, a native of Turkey, drew up the plans for the city. But to truly communicate his vision, he needed a 3D model. He turned to Nicoleta Adamo-Valani, a research scientist in Purdue's Envision Center for Data Perceptualization. She and a team of graduate and undergraduate students toiled for 2 months creating a fly-through depiction of a city ribbed with wide boulevards, anchored by transportation hubs, and divided into distinct hotel, business, residential, and entertainment districts.
The reason why Dr. Sozan came to us, he had tried to explain his idea multiple times to the municipality of Istanbul, but they wouldn't understand it. And I think once the animation was completed and he actually went there and showed the CD with the real animation, I think it had a big impact, and they really understood what his plan was and what he was planning on doing. So it has a very, it has an incredible power to convince people and obviously to make dreams come true.
The animation contains 9,000 images. Each image normally takes 20 minutes to render. The entire job would take a single computer more than 3 months to complete. Instead, Adamo Valani's team employed the TerraGrid distributing rendering environment created by information technology research scientists at Purdue. The Condor software connects 6,000 computers on campus. Each one contributed to the rendering when it was not otherwise in use. With the project deadline looming, Terra DRE completed the job in hours instead of months.
We were tasked with modeling the city from based on the city plan, texturing, which means assigning the materials to the buildings, lighting the environment, and then animating a camera that goes around the entire city to show what the city looks like, and rendering the final animation.
The Purdue researchers will next create an accurate visualization of what would happen to Istanbul if a major earthquake strikes. That animation will likely depict acres of collapsed buildings. Narrow streets filled with rubble will prevent rescuers from reaching trapped victims. Sozan estimates that retrofitting Istanbul to make it safer in case of earthquake would cost about $50 billion. That kind of expense begins to make a new city look financially feasible.
In that when this satellite city is built, the buildings will be built according to the most recent technical standards so that they will be safe in the event of an earthquake. And we intend to work in a lot of cyber information into it, a lot of computer controls for the city, for its transportation. It'll be a modern city by every definition of the term.
Sozan hopes that his research will be useful well beyond Istanbul over the next few decades. Sozan says rising ocean waters caused by global warming threaten to turn seaside cities into ponds, not unlike post-Katrina New Orleans. A global catastrophe that could be addressed by Sozan's satellite city concept. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.